Many people kill good relationships around them by transferring aggression to others. That need to stop. We must stop killing good relationships around us because of the way we transfer aggression to others. I understand that hurt feelings are inevitable in relationships, but it is how we cope with our pain and negative experiences that actually matters. You need to understand that sometimes people hurt us because they are also in pain or hurting in some way. In other words, hurting people hurt people. So what do I mean? I mean some people won't hurt you intentionally. The moment you know this, it will help you to act with compassion and mercy, rather than in anger or any other way that could exasperate the problem. Someone once said, "If you never heal from what hurt you, you'll bleed on people who didn't cut you." How true is that? If you never heal from the hurt you feel, then you'll find yourself bleeding on people who didn't hurt you. So you really need to get over your hurts and pains in order for you to live a fulfilling life that God wants you to live. Most times, the hurt you feel is often nothing but an interpretation you have made about your experience. Personally, I don't get mad at the people who do me wrong, but instead, I try to put myself in their shoes and follow what the Word of God says. The Bible says in Ephesians 4 verse 32, "Be kind to one another, tender-hearted and forgiving one another as God in Christ forgave you." That's my mindset. And another reason I have this mindset is because of what I said earlier. It takes someone that is hurting inside to actually hurt others. I advise you to have this mindset too. Let's all be Christ-like. Ask yourself, how would Christ act in this situation? I'm sure whatever your answer is will be in alignment with the Word of God. It takes someone that is hurting inside to hurt others. Most times, our lives are the extension of our previous hurts. Yes, the hurt you feel is an interpretation you have made about your experience. So do not carry your previous hurts to your present relationships. It will only cause more damages. You must always ensure that you have thoroughly dealt with your previous hurts before moving into a new relationship. Or else, your present partner will be a victim of your unhealed hurts. You can put yourself in the shoes of your partner and imagine how frustrating that is. It is very frustrating. Please and please, don't wound others to heal yourself. And if you find yourself doing that, please stop now. Make sure you heal before you go into a new relationship. Or else, your next partner will be the object and target of your pain. Okay, enough of talking about the problem. Let's talk about the way out. How can you productively handle previous hurts and abuses so that they don't ruin your present and future relationships? Number 1. Don't suppress your hurt. The truth is, it's not easy to communicate how you feel to the person who hurt you. Even if you are able to tell them, there's no assurance that they will react or respond the way you want them to. So what's the way out? Telling a trusted person or a matured friend can help you heal and overcome your hurts. Discuss with a close family member or friend and explain what happened to them. Get their viewpoint and opinion about the problem and work with them to resolve your feelings. Yes, work with them. Number 2. Forgiveness. Yes, forgive yourself and the person that hurt you. Unforgiveness is like a poison. Many people ruin their health and their lives by taking the poison of bitterness, resentment and unforgiveness. Matthew 18 verses 23 to 35 tells us that if we do not forgive people, we get turned over to the torturers. If you have a problem in this area or have ever had one, I'm sure you can bear witness to what I'm saying. It's torture to have hateful thoughts toward another person rolling around inside your head. Unforgiveness is like drinking poison and hoping it will kill your enemies. Let me ask you, is that even possible? The answer is no. So, forgiveness is the first step towards healing and happiness. When you forgive, you heal, and when you let go, then you'll grow. Mark 11 verses 22 through 26 clearly teaches us that unforgiveness hinders our faith from working, because the Father can't forgive our sins if we don't forgive other people. The Bible says we reap what we sow. Sow mercy and you'll reap mercy. Sow judgment and you'll reap judgment. So which one do you want? The choice is yours. But I encourage you to please do yourself a favor and forgive. Forgive yourself and the person that hurt you, and the Almighty God will heal and restore you. Number 3. Move on with your life. Yes, you have to let go and move on with your life. The agreeable question to ask after a hurt is, where do I go from here? The truth is, if your hurt is properly handled, it can give you direction or a redirection in life. Let go of the hurt and move on with your life. Your life is too precious. Do not waste it thinking and getting angry over what happened in the past. I know it is easier said than done. But please remind yourself of your strengths and of all the things that have brought you to this point in your life. Also, remember that God loves you and He has great plans for you. The Bible says in Psalm 34 verse 18, "The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit." The brokenhearted and crushed in spirit. Whether you are aware of it or not, the Lord is near you. So in conclusion, every hurt you experience gives you an opportunity to learn more about yourself. It gives you a chance to learn more about your values, rules, boundaries, and personal expectations. It gives you an opportunity to learn more about others and about how you relate to other people socially and intimately. And as you learn, you will grow. And as you grow, you will make better choices and decisions in the future, which will help you to manage and minimize your feelings of hurt far more effectively. Like someone once said, don't ruin other people's happiness just because you can't find your own. May God help you in Jesus' name.